Welcome, everyone, to the light of Zion. The light of Zion is our God's word. Yahuwah's word is a lamp for our feet and a light for the road that we travel. Shine your light, O Yahuwah. Let it lead us to your holy mountains. Shine your light, O Yahuwah. Let it lead us back to Zion. Shine your light and let it guide us on our journey back to you. Shine your light, for it is good for me. And with that, I say, welcome to the light of Zion. Hello again, and it is my privilege to come to you again with another presentation coming from the light of Zion. I know you are being blessed and you are being benefited as you give attention to information coming from the light of Zion. And the light of Zion is God's word. Our God has foretold from long ago that in the last days that he is going to pour out his spirit on the sons and daughters of Israel, and knowledge of the word will increase for the chosen ones of Israel, and we will make this knowledge known to all, for all to know. So you are paying attention, and I hope you are being blessed and being enlightened or being built up in your faith as you give attention to the words coming from the light of Zion. For God is the one showing us the way, opening our eyes to see the things that he has been doing and the things that he has been working out for the salvation of his people, of Israel. So today I come to you with another interesting title, and this one is titled God's Judgment on the Presumptuous and the Wicked Ones of the Earth. Yes, God's judgment, or his decision on the presumptuous and the wicked ones of the earth. But the question is, who are the presumptuous ones and who are the wicked ones of the earth? So, yes, the end day of all the presumptuous and the wicked ones of the earth is coming. But what is presumptuousness? Presumptuousness. It is from the root word to presume, or to think, or move or an idea of thinking ahead or moving ahead without finding out the facts. When a person is presumptuous, he assumed that this will continue to be this way. He assumed that this will be this what it is, but he does not have the facts. So all the ones that have this kind of thinking without finding out the facts are the presumptuous ones of the earth. So in the book of Malachi chapter 4 verse 1, there is written, say, for look, the day is coming burning like a furnace, when all the presumptuous ones and all those practicing wickedness will become like stubble. So the coming day will certainly devour them, says Yahuwah of armies, and it will leave them neither root nor branch. So Yahuwah has said and has decreed that a day is coming when all the presumptuous ones, those who keep thinking ahead or moving ahead thinking that, oh, this will not happen, God does not exist, or he will not do what he said he will do. So the day that is coming, that is burning like fire, will completely devour all such ones who are presumptuous at heart. Many have continued to practice wickedness because they are presumptuously thinking that God does not exist, or that he will not do anything, or he will not carry out the judgment that he has said that he will carry out. These are the presumptuous ones of the earth. Yes, but the day of their end is coming. So the great day of Yahuwah will devour and completely exterminate from off the earth all the presumptuous ones and those practicing what is wicked. In the book of Jeremiah chapter 46 verse 28, there it is revealed and written, Yahuwah said this, "So do not be afraid, my servant Jacob, declares Yahuwah, for I am with you. I will make an extermination among all the nations where I despise you, but you I will not exterminate. I will discipline you to the proper degree, but I will by no means leave you unpunished." So Yahuwah has revealed that the day is coming when he's going to do what? Make extermination among all the nations where Israel has been despised to bear punishment for our error. So that day, all the presumptuous ones will be exterminated, as he foretold in the book of Malachi, chapter 4, verse 1. So that day, we leave them with no root or branch to continue to carry on with their wickedness and with their presumptuousness. So all such ones who are presumptuous at heart will be completely cut off from the earth. So yes, when that day arrives, Yahuwah will make an extermination among the nations where he has scattered Israel. But Israel's descendants will not be completely exterminated. So let's consider the fearful and great day of Yahuwah God. Concerning this day that Yahuwah will execute his judgment, in the book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 9 to 11, there it is written, Yahuwah said this, "Say, proclaim this among the nations, prepare for war, stir up mighty men, let all the soldiers draw near, say, let them advance, say, beat your plowshares into swords and your pruning shears into spears. So let the weak one say, I am powerful. So come and help all you surrounding nations. Assemble together to that place. Oh Yahuwah, bring down your powerful ones. So let the nations be aroused and come up to the valley of Jehoshaphat. For there I will sit in order to judge all the surrounding nations." So Yahuwah has warned the nations and he has told them to do what? To prepare for war. For this day is coming when he's going to put an end to all the presumptuous ones of the earth and all those practicing wickedness. So why is Yahuwah going to war with all the nations? Why is Yahuwah going to go to war with all the nations? Well, in the book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 1 and 2, there is written, so for look, in those days and in that time when I bring back the captives of Judah and Jerusalem, say, I will also gather together all the nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat. I will enter into judgment with them there in behalf of my people and my inheritance Israel. For they scattered them among the nations, and they divided up my land among themselves. So the nations has been presumptuous by what? Scattering Israel, the people of God, among the nations and put them into slavery. And they divided up their land among themselves, the land of Israel among themselves. So they have been acting presumptuously, thinking that God will not do anything. That God will not do a thing. But Yahuwah said they should do what? Prepare for war. Because this day is coming. And he invites all the mighty ones of the nations, the soldiers and all of them, to prepare for battle. Because this day is coming when he's going to do what? Fight a war with the presumptuous ones of the earth, the nations. Yes, the nations scattered all Israel, the human children among themselves, the human children of God among them, among the nations, and they took over the land inheritance of Israel. For this, the great and fearful day of Yahuwah is coming because of what the nations have done to the children of God by taking over their land and their inheritances, and also for putting them into slavery among the nations. So Yahuwah's great day is coming. So Yahuwah is coming with his powerful angels. He is coming for this war with his powerful angels. In the book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 11, is written, come and help all you surrounding nations, assemble together to that place. O Yahuwah, bring down your powerful ones. So even if all the nations, if they want, they can be called, join in alliance to help each other to fight. If they can, they should join each other and be ready to fight, because Yahuwah is coming down with his powerful ones to fight with the nations, for they have acted presumptuously towards the chosen people of God, Israel. And because of this, the great day of Yahuwah is coming upon the earth. So Yahuwah is coming with his powerful angels to carry out his decrees and judgments of long ago. In the book of Psalms, chapter 76, verse 8 to 9, there is written, from heaven you pronounce judgment. The earth was afraid and was silent. When God rose up to execute judgment, to save all the meek of the earth. So Yahuwah pronounced this judgment in heaven, and the earth should be afraid. because Jehovah is coming to execute judgment in order to save the meek ones of the earth. So Jehovah will carry out the foretold vengeance of his foretold vengeance on his adversary, the serpent, the devil, and his produced human children, the nations. So Jehovah will carry out this foretold vengeance on the adversary, his adversaries, the serpent, the devil. He is the chief adversary, and the chief adversary, the devil, has produced children, human children, that is the nations. In the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verse 15, there is written, "And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and her offspring. So he will crush your head, and you will strike him in the heel." So from beginning, Yahuwah has foretold that he's produced human children, that is Israel, will return and take over the promised land territory for the fourth generation, or for the fourth cycle. He has foretold that this will happen. In the book of Genesis, chapter 15, verse 16, there is written, but they will return here in the fourth generation, because the era of the Amorite has not yet reached its full measure." So Yahuwah has foretold that Israel, the descendants of Abraham, will return for the fourth time to inherit the promised land that he gave to Abraham and his chosen descendants to inherit. They will return even for the fourth generation to inherit it. So, and Yahuwah will carry out, we see that this is carried out. That is why he is coming with his powerful angels to war with the nations who has taken over the land of his people Israel. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32, verse 36, is written, Yahuwah revealed and foretold. He said, "Vengeance is mine, and retribution at the appointed time when their foot slip. For the day of their disaster is near, and what awaits them will come quickly." So Yahuwah has foretold that he will take this vengeance upon the nations, that the day of their disaster is coming quickly. The day of their disaster is near, and what awaits them will come quickly. So he has foretold and warned the nations long ago that this is coming, that he will take vengeance concerning the land of his people. So in the book of Zephaniah, chapter 3, verse 8, there is written, "So keep yourself in expectation of me, declares Yahuwah, until the day when I rise up to take plunder. For my judiciary decision is to gather nations, to assemble kingdoms, to pour out on them my indignation, all of my burning anger. For by the fire of my zeal, the whole earth will be consumed." So like he foretold, he's going to cause an extermination among the nations. So he warned the nations to do what? To keep in expectation of him. For his desire is to do what? Gather nations and gather kingdoms, and to pour out on them his burning anger. So yes, Yahuwah is coming with his angels to execute this judgment that he has foretold of long ago. In the book of Matthew, chapter 13, verse 39 to 41, there the Messiah Yahushua revealed this. He said, "And the enemy who sowed them is the devil, and the harvest is a conclusion of the system of things, and the reapers are angels. So therefore, just as the weeds are collected and burned with fire, so it will be in the conclusion of the system of things. The Son of Man will send out his angels, and they will collect out from his kingdom all the things that cause stumbling and people who practice lawlessness. So all the presumptuous ones and all that practice wickedness, all the people that think that God will not carry out the things he has foretold that he will carry out." Yahushua said that he's coming with the angels, and there we gather all the wicked ones and all the presumptuous ones, all the seed of the devil. He will gather them and collect them and do what? And burn them up with fire. Yes, the angels will do that. So the nations has been given a notice to do what? To prepare for battle, because it's coming. In the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 32, verse 39 to 43, there is written, "See now that I am he, and there are no other gods apart from me. I put to death and I make alive, and I wound and I will heal. And no one can rescue from my hand, for I raise my hand to the heavens, and I swear, as surely as I am alive, if I sharpen my sword and prepare my hands for judgment, I will pay back vengeance on my adversaries and bring retribution to those who hate me. And I will make my arrow drunk with blood, and my sword will eat flesh, with the blood of the slain and the captives, with the heads of the leaders of the enemy. So be glad, you nations, with his people, for he will avenge the blood of his servants, and he will repay vengeance to his adversaries, and will make atonement for the land of his people." So Yahuwah said he swore, he raised his hand and an oath and swore that he will take this vengeance on the nations, on his adversary, the devil, and his children that he has produced on earth. So he swore that he will take this vengeance at the appointed time. So his arrow will be drunk with blood, and his sword will eat flesh with the blood of the slain and the captives. So Yahuwah is coming with his angels to execute this vengeance and this judgment that he foretold long ago upon the nations. So who are the presumptuous ones? The presumptuous ones presume that Yahuwah have forgotten about his decreed decisions of long ago. So thus they think that his decrees and decisions will no longer be executed. Such ones that think this way are of the presumptuous ones. For they think that Yahuwah will no longer carry out the decrees that he has foretold long ago, or thinking that he has forgotten the decrees that he has made long ago that he will carry out, all such ones are of the presumptuous ones. The presumptuous ones assume that Yahuwah God does not really exist. They think that everything has continued the way it is, that nature, they call it nature. They say nature, okay? They did not, instead of giving credit to the living God, they think that God does not exist. Anyone thinking this way is thinking presumptuously. He's a presumptuous one. The presumptuous ones pre-assume that all are the human children of God. And you have had so many said this way, oh, are we not all God's children? That is thinking presumptuously. My friend, we are not all God's children. For the devil produced children, and God produced his own children. So thinking this way that all are human children, God's children, that is a person thinking presumptuously. The presumptuous ones pre-assume that Yahuwah God loves everybody. They think that God loves everybody. But really, when you look at what is written, God does not love everybody. The presumptuous ones pre-assume that all humans can now mix and intermarry and become one human family. That is thinking presumptuously. They think that all humans can now mix, intermarry, and become one family. That is presumptuously thinking, my friends. The presumptuous ones pre-assume that all humans now worship and serve the same God. Not according to what is written, because what is written is that the devil will produce children that will, because the devil produced children, human children that are serving and doing his will, and God produced human children that are to serve and to do his will. So the presumptuous ones presume also that after death, humans go to either heaven or hell. That is thinking presumptuously. But when you consider the words of the living God, that is not true. The presumptuous ones pre-assume that things will continue the way it is now, that everything will continue the way it is now, and that wicked will continue to be in charge of the earth. But that is thinking presumptuously. So all such presumptuous ones, their end is coming. Yes, Yahuwah said that he's there, he's coming with his angels to bring vengeance on the presumptuous ones of the earth. Who are the presumptuous ones? The presumptuous ones pre-assume that Yahuwah will not execute the judgment and the vengeance he swore that he will execute on behalf of his people. They think he will not, but that is thinking presumptuously. The presumptuous ones pre-assume that there is no consequence for error against God. They think they can do whatever they like against God and there is no consequence. They think they can break his commandments and there will be no consequences. They think that they will hurt and bruise the children of God and there will be no consequences. That is thinking presumptuously, my friend. The presumptuous ones pre-assume that there is no God and therefore they keep on practicing their wickedness, the wicked things they do, because they think there is no God. And some of them presume that the devil is God, so they serve, they give themselves to serving the devil. But well, that is presumptuous thinking, presumptuously, my friend. The presumptuous ones presume that they are by their power, wisdom, and help of the help of their God, the devil, that they have placed themselves on top above all other people. That is thinking presumptuously, my friend. For God is the one that has allowed these things to continue to this point. So all these presumptuous ones, all these pre-assumptions are false. That is why all the presumptuous ones of the earth will be exterminated off the earth in the day of Yahuwah, in the day that Yahuwah will take his action. So all these pre-assumptions, they are all false. They are all false. So all the presumptuous ones will be exterminated off the surface of the earth when Yahuwah's day arrives. Therefore, it is written that the day that is coming will leave for the presumptuous ones and the wicked ones no root and no branch. That is, no children to continue to carry out their wickedness. But like it was in the days of Noah, the wicked will be completely washed away or wiped off the face of the earth. So I hope this message brings enlightenment to you and understanding to you and help you to avoid acting presumptuously, because all the presumptuous ones of the earth and those that practice wickedness will be wiped off the earth. So seek Yahuwah, you people, while there is time, before his great day arrive. Call upon his name for your salvation. Perhaps you will be preserved in the day of Yahuwah taking action. So until I come to you next time, share this video. Share with your family, share with others, help the presumptuous ones awake while there is still time. So until I come to you next time, continue to remain blessed. Thank you.